Hi, and welcome to another edition of Recreation Review. I'm Frank Pizzo. I'm here with Tammy Litkevich, and we're here to cover the rest of the summer. Tammy, summer's already upon us, and we're already talking about fall programming, but we have the rest of the summer.
It's going.
We have a lot of stuff to cover. Not a ton of stuff, but we have a bunch of things we want to make sure you are aware of. We are going to put a lot of information out again. You can contact us many different ways. Our Facebook page is probably the best way to get the up-to-date information. Again, Carl put this all at the bottom for us, but it's www.facebook.com/myctpr. Call our office anytime, 286-9336, and our website at clintontownship-mi.gov or clintontownship.com. But actually, it's clintontownship-gov right now to get to our website.
Yeah, that's where we have all of our active information.
There's too many web things out there, too many things to worry about. So why don't you kick us off with programs that the residents need to be aware of for rest of the summer.
All right, well, we brought them up last time, but we have a lot of early childhood programming going on. So we have a new one actually starting right after the 4th of July, so coming up probably while this one's on TV. So I'm excited to see that get going. But we do have a lot of rooms still available in the later classes. You sign up for each class individually. So what we have is we have our Outdoor Explorers, we have our Passport to Safety program, and we have our Preschool Day Camp. Those run Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday afternoons. You can sign up for classes at 1, 3, or 6 o'clock. And then each class has a different like topic or theme. So you can look through our brochure, go to the website, go to Facebook, any of those places, or give us a call and we'll let you know what's going those days. But you sign up based on what's available, what fits your schedule, and what you want your child to go to.
So you actually price broke it out and
exactly.
You individualize it so they can pick an activity they want to do.
Yep, you can.
Like
you
we said, choose. We said in the show earlier, a while ago, we talked about how we change our programs through evaluation process. We change this program to meet the needs of the community. They're looking for an hour and a half. We don't have 5 hours or 6 hours. You know, nowadays, children and parents are so busy. So we try to micro and make these a little smaller. So an hour and a half, and you can get to all these activities and. They can handpick what they want to do. They're not committed for an entire summer. They can pick the ones they want to do. The time slot that we're having trouble with is 3 o'clock. So is that this time?
Yep, that's one. Middle time slot.
So we got openings at 3 o'clock. The other ones are filling up. We want to thank CNG newspaper. They did an article on the new program. And a lot of our programs, when they start, we start out small. Like Daddy Daughter started with like 25 couples. And then we went to 1,500 people. You know, we're doing the Great American Backyard Campout. This is already going to be on. You know, we've already done it, but we started with 5 families, you know, and it's grown to 10 families, and now we got 20 sites, and that eventually is going to take up the whole soccer field. So I'm excited about these early childhood programs. And parents, you're asking for early childhood programming. It's out there, and we're going to be doing some pre-3 programming. So kids before the age of 3, you can look forward to some activities, which we're hoping this fall when we can kick off some pre-3.
Hopefully.
Well, we're hoping,
we'll
right?
We'll get something out there.
Well, let's jump over to flag football. I've got flag football. Again, I brag about our flag football program, but we got to register by July 18th to get that better price, right? July 18th, or is that the
July
deadline?
July 18th is the cutoff. So after that, you'll be on a wait list.
All right.
We'll see where we're at with teams.
So we need you in by July 18th. Yep. Flag football here in Clinton Township is dear to my heart. I've been an assistant coach in it. My son's played in it. It's the best football. I brag about it all the time. Coaches out there for the middle school, they talk about our program. They say, we love your program. It's real football. Nothing against the NFL program. Nothing against other tackle leagues out there. Yeah, that's real. That's real football for sure. The tackle leagues. But sometimes it's not what parents or what I guess society is leaning to. We've got a lot of concussion problems in the United States and in the NFL.
Yep.
And our league has been for years talking about it. Now I guess they're catching up with us. But we wear karate style helmets. We don't have contact head to head, but we do have contact with the body. So we still need to wear those helmets for concussion. But, you know, even my son signed up my brother signed up his son for a program, and they're wearing these helmets, and now they're selling him an app to wear where he can take this app and he can watch how many times his son's getting hit in the head. And if it gets to a certain point, I'm not kidding you, it gets to a certain point, then they know that their kid has been hit too many times and they pull him out, something like that. But the app is $150 just for the app, not signing up for the football program. And my question is, what if the kid throws a helmet on the ground when he's mad about a call, or if he gets frustrated and goes back, throws it down?
Well, waste of a hit.
Yeah, that's a hit. My son's going to be pulled out. Ours is flag football. It's touch, you know, it's flags. There is still contact at the line. Real football. Quarterbacks run with the ball, which some leagues don't, which cracks me up in the NFL and in college and high school. Kids will be running with the football as a quarterback. There's going to be contact at the line. They're going to be sore when they get up the next day. Captains of Frazier's football high school team this year played in our league. John Perry, Callahan, Drew Callahan, captains of Chippewa Valley this year that are going on to play collegiate football, played in our league for 3 years. Got to get pictures up of those guys, though, all those kids. They played in our league. They went through our league the entire time, got to the middle school. The middle school coaches say, hey, did you do tackle? They're like, no, we played flag football at Clinton Township. They're like, fantastic. We don't have to teach them how to tackle properly. And not that all tackle leagues teach improper tackle. I don't want to say that. Just saying the coaches have told me we like when they come from your league because they're not, they don't have some bad habits.
Yeah.
They're starting from the concept of football, which is what we do. We teach concept of football, catching, throwing, scheme. They're still a very fast game. You see those older kids playing, it's a very, very fast game. Games are, even the older kids now are going to 7-on-7. They want smaller. We're doing that stuff. We did make one change this year. We're going to try to keep them in the schools they're playing in. So if you did like NFL and we asked why did you like NFL, they said, we like their shirts. Well, okay, they got NFL shirts. We still have good shirts.
Yep.
We have safe equipment. What did you really like? We like that our kids can play with their other kids in their school. So we're going to try that this year, right?
Yeah.
So if you've never done a flag football league, I'm bragging about it. Every time we have the best flag football league around. I know Westerner does a great job out there. I can plug them in Sterling Heights. If you go watch it, there's a lot more contact than ours. Mm-hmm. But they do a good job with their football. They're a very popular program. Come into Clinton Township, try our program out. You'll be very satisfied with it. And your high school coaches and your middle school coaches are going to be thrilled you played with us. So I guess I plug that enough. Ages, again, are 6 to 11. We have $86.50 for residents, which is ridiculously low. My son plays at Joe Dumars basketball, and it's $150 a pop just to play basketball. Yeah. And they don't give you a shirt. We give you a lot of stuff for $86.50. You can't touch that even with Little League baseball for that price for $86.50.
Yeah. That's...
Parents are tailgating in our parking lot.
It's fun. Yeah, I love it.
You've done it, right?
Last year, me and Emily split the game so we could all go out there because it's fun to be out there. It's a good environment. It's
all right.
Everyone getting along.
It's flag football then. See, I got to get rid of these cards, but Johnny said I could throw them, but I'm going to hang on to them.
All right, so football 6 to 11. Let's go back to the younger kids
again.
Yeah,
let's go back to them.
Another session of Sporties for Shorties. This one's good. It sells out pretty much every time. So,
it's almost sold out, right? I mean, it's the fall.
Yeah, we got two different time frames. So this one starts September 9th to October 7th. We have sessions at 6 o'clock and 7 o'clock. The 7 o'clock is actually the one that's almost full already. So
I got a theory on it. I think they're eating dinner at about 5 or 6, mm-hmm. and then they're going to go play. They're not in a pool, so they have to wait an hour. I'm joking.
It's a classic program that we've been doing for I don't even know how many years at this point, but
you're looking at me like I would know because I can tell you we brought it here when my kids were probably 3 years old and 4 years old, and she's 18, so 14 years or a long time we've been doing it.
Long time.
And it sells out all the time. So
yep.
How many spots? I know we just had a staff meeting, not many spots left for the fall.
Yeah.
Maybe 10?
Probably around there, yeah.
All right. 10 spots left. Infomercial, 10 spots left. Give us a call,
286-9336.
Again, that's 586-286-9336. Register for these programs. We're on Facebook. We talked about that. Got to get a hold of us. These programs sell out, and it's so frustrating for us when a parent calls and says, how is Erie Day Camp already sold out? Ottawa Day Camp already sold out. 150 kids. I got to plug the playground program. It's still going on this summer. You can still get in it, but Erie, 150. Ottawa, 150. Huron, just doing awesome. Without a latchkey program, over 90 kids sign up. We service over 800. We saw that yesterday. Over 800 children alone in our day camp program, and the numbers are only going to grow through the summer. Great program. Again, give us a call. We'll tell you all about that. We weren't prepared for it here, but I know it's Monday through Thursday, 8:30 to 3. Active, passive activities all day long. Call 286-9336 and register. They'll tell you more about it. We have other things to cover. And I got the Gresh Cruise.
That's a big one.
Grass Cruise is actually an independent event from the township, but we assist with it. I just want to plug that they're Sunday, August 3rd. It's been going on for years. It runs from 14 Mile Road to Harrington. So we got our own little niche on Gratiot. Runs from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. We don't want any rain, so whoever's on the rain committee, make sure you have no rain on that day, because I know no one wants to bring their cars out when it's like that, but they want to go out and have a good time. So you'll see a lot of establishments, businesses along the way that support the Gratiot Cruise that have tents out there. Mm-hmm. They bring bands. There's clowns. There's face painters. It's a great festive atmosphere. I call it like a mini Woodward cruise because it's in our town. It's our town, but they come from everywhere. Some great cars. I love just sitting on the side of the road and seeing some of the cool cars that are out there because I used to have a convertible. I sold it. So
I know.
It was a little one.
My grandpa was always into cars growing up, so I still think it's fun. Get out there, check it all out.
I loved it. I go out there and And I just like seeing Roscoe. Roscoe's one of my favorite. I see him walking up and down the streets, and I love all the sponsors that are out there and putting up tents and providing food and drinks. And just check out the Grassroots Cruise August 3rd. The Kids Zone, I don't want to see it on TV for sure, but it's usually at the 16 Mile Road corner of Gratiot, the
Mount Clemens,
Community Bank. Is it? I want to make sure I say the right one, but it's the MCG building.
Yes.
And we are there at the corner of 16 and Gratiot. Something you got to look forward to again. And that's later in the year, so it's August 3rd. So I don't know if you have something coming up earlier than August 3rd. I have a bunch in here. But
I'm going later. I'm going into the fall.
So we actually, Parks and Recreation, just so we make this clear, people say to me, well, isn't your job just the summertime and then you don't do anything after that? I mean.
Oh, yeah.
We just kick back and relax the rest of the year, right? We'll tell them what we're doing just coming up in August and September. And then we have daddy-daughter dances and trick-or-treat trails. And we have events that go all year round in Clinton Township Parks and Recreation. So our summer is definitely busy, but we're busy all year round.
Yep, absolutely. All right, so we have the Grand Experience Trip. We gave this one a little plug last time, but we still have a few spots left. It is filling up, and it fills up quick because this is a joint program that we run with a lot of communities in southeastern Michigan. So you can be from anywhere. So if you're hearing about this here, but you know, your out-of-town family, whatever it may be,
on Facebook. We'll have non-residents watching this. So
exactly.
They can be a part of it.
So we have the Grand Experience Trip. What this is, we will leave on Monday, October 20th. And I'm sure we'll have a nice board up there with all the information. Because this one's a big one. We got tons going on. But basically what it is, it's a three-day trip up to Mackinac Island. You get to stay at the Grand Hotel. All of your meals included. You get round-trip transportation, different games, activities, events. There's different, like a new schedule of activities every day that they put up on the board. And it can be anything from maybe you get a kitchen tour, wine tasting, a bocce ball tournament, jewelry making, like anything you can imagine. They have tons going on. And this one, it's amazing to me. I can't even comprehend how it happens. Price is starting at $555.
That's for a couple or per person?
That's per person.
For how many days? Sorry,
It's a Monday to Thursday.
Whoa, that's a long time.
Yeah,
The Grand Hotel.
At the Grand Hotel, which
I stayed there 2 days. I can just tell you, I went with my wife and we stayed for a couple days there. It was many years ago before we had kids, and the Grand Hotel the food is phenomenal. I'm a big food connoisseur. I love food, and the food was fantastic. To stay at the Grand Hotel is like historic for me. I went there and I was like, wow, this is like history. I'm at the Grand Hotel, and it's an iconic place for Michigan, but let alone nationally. You think people come here for their honeymoons. People plan their weddings on this island. We have it right here in our backyard. Yeah, it's a 3.5-4 hour trip to drive up there.
Yeah.
Take the
ferry ride.
They're real fast now. And I went there and I stayed there, and I'm telling you, the food was great. The price for that for 4 days, I think I paid that for a weekend when I went.
Easy.
It was very expensive. So Grand Hotel, if you've never done it in your lifetime, this is a bucket list thing, I think. Definitely, if you live in Clinton, I mean, if you live in Michigan, you should be a part of the Grand Experience, you know. I think I think for the price, I might have to look at it again myself because Karen, a lot. I've been really busy and not really spending a lot of time at home, so I got to check into that. Don't watch this part. Make sure Karen's not watching this. I guess I'm going to jump to some of the stuff we have coming up soon, real soon. We have our concert series back in Clinton Township. I'm really excited. The budget, you know, we went down. We lost a lot of money. You know, times are really tough. And the elected officials and accounting did a great job. And, you know, they had pinched all the pennies they could, make sure that we're here. You know, the recreation department's still here. And then with the times, not that they're a lot better, but the times at least stopped. You know, we stopped getting all those foreclosures. And houses actually went up in value a little bit. They brought some of that money back to the rec department. They said, let's bring back some community events. And we love the concert series. So the concert series is going to be back in Clinton Township. We're very excited about it. And we always kick it off now with the fireworks concert. That's the July 9th event. It's our lead sponsor on that is First State Bank. And I recently was there with Dean Reynolds and Kathleen, the marketing director for First State Bank. And why don't we go to First State Bank and see what we talked about that day?
Hi, I'm Dean Reynolds. I'm here today with Frank, our director of Parks and Rec. Frank. And Kathleen, who is the director of marketing for First State Bank, our hometown bank, and they are also the major sponsor for our fireworks concert. Kathleen, how are you doing today?
I'm very well, thank you.
Very good. Would you like to tell us a little bit about First State Bank and why it's our hometown bank?
I can do that. First State Bank opened, we are right now in our latest and newest location in Clinton Township. This is a full service branch that used to be the former Chelios Chili, or as we all remembered, also the Silo. It is a branch that if you need a loan, if you need a deposit, if you need an investment, this is a full service branch. We have everybody in this office. It's also our second branch in Clinton Township. We have one at Grossbeck and Hall Road, and that one's been there for quite a long time. We have 9 other locations in throughout Macomb County, from the south, from East Point, where we started in 1917, to Richmond, so all the way in between. We are the only bank that's headquartered in Macomb County. When I started, that wasn't true, but now we are the only bank that's located in Macomb County. And people always ask, why do you sponsor these many events? And one of the things that in it with a community bank is, if we are going to thrive, the community has to thrive. And that's because all the deposits that we take in are then lent out in the form of homes and loans to businesses. They're not like some of the large banks where they go to other states or they go overseas. So everything is local in Macomb County. So we are very dedicated to Macomb County, and we're thrilled to be sponsoring the fireworks for the second year in Clinton Township. Last year was our first year in anticipation of opening this office, and we're thrilled to do it again.
Well, we're thrilled to have you. We're happy, and we follow County Executive Mark Hackles, Make Macomb Your Home, because that's First State Bank. Tell us a little bit about, now last year you had this wonderful face painting, and I say wonderful because it would be like going down to Disney and Animal Kingdom. They did the entire face.
And they're fast.
Yes, they are extremely fast.
This year again we're going to have 3 face painters, and we have, we've kind of perfected this over the years, and it's complimentary. Kids of all ages. Dean could have his face painted. Frank could have it. I am the only employee who always gets her face painted, and then my picture is sent all around the bank. But
which face painting do you do?
I've had butterflies. I had last year. It was a creepy tiger. It even creeped me out. And when I came home, my son was like, "Go wash your face now." But we were going to have 3 of them again. It's going to start at 5:45. We'll be there for 3 hours. Again, it's complimentary, and they can do pretty much anything. Some of the young kids do really creepy things. It's amazing. The smaller they are, the creepier they can be. And we've had plenty of teenagers there, and they can be done in 2-3 minutes. The face painters we use work for Tiger Stadium, so they know how to get a face painted very quickly.
See, now last year I saw Spider-Man. Somebody did a Spider-Man face, which was really cool. It didn't look like paint. It looked like a mask.
Who want to be little princesses, they leave as little princesses with glitter all over, and the boys have blood and guts. And truly, the smaller they are, the vampires and blood.
And I know the kids that come to us, and they rave about all that. As a parent, it's wonderful that it's all free, that you provide that for everybody.
And some people try to pay us. It's like, no.
Well, and that's kind of unique, our event, which I know Frank's aware of, but I don't know if we are really the last event in Macomb County, probably the state, since the economy started to turn better, that everything is still free. It doesn't matter what it is. If you're going to our photo booth to get a picture for a memory, if you're going on any of the carnival rides, the bounce houses, going to see Roscoe for a balloon animal. Everything is free other than the refreshments and the food. And the glow sticks. So there's no charge
that
for parking.
Is rare. You don't see that in recreation in any department that I see. That carnival rides, usually you'd buy in a wristband and spend $20 a child. Go get your face painted. You're paying another $5 a child.
I've heard $10.
Ten.
I paid ten dollars for face painting.
Yours would be yours. 10 or 15.
So that's just great. And we couldn't do it without the support of.
With you being our major sponsor, you've allowed us to bring in. We're going to have 7 carnival rides this year.
That's great.
And when we say carnival rides, they're not the huge ones, but
for the kids.
For the kids, and I think they can be up to 250 pounds. So that's a big kid.
You could make it. Yeah. You can now, too.
You're right. Now I can, too. I forgot about that. But it's a fun event. Hopefully, we have a nice night. We've been really fortunate. This is our 7th year. And even though we've had a little rain once in a while, it's always turned out beautiful at the end. But, again, without you, we wouldn't be able to keep expanding this.
Yeah, and myself, I'm a resident of the township, and I've never been to First State Bank because I was coming down Hayes when I didn't even realize it's a beautiful location.
This is a beautiful
location. They need to come in and check this out. bring your money to First State Bank.
Well, and First State Bank, one of our slogans is that you can bank big but still bank local. We have all the same things at the big and more. We have, look, I have a prop. Personalized debit cards. What picture would you put on your debit card? This is my son's art. The carnival. Fireworks.
Cool. So you can put anything on there, and they do that right
now? Well, maybe not, not a logo, right? I mean, like a tiger logo. And do you know what most people put on their cards?
Their kids.
Their dogs.
Really?
Their dogs.
I don't have a dog, so I put my kids on mine.
If I have a dog, I could put my dog and my kid.
And you could do fireworks.
And my wife, I could do a family picture.
There you go. That is a nice option, too.
And you know, one thing that I do like with First State Bank is I don't know, you probably know this, but a lot of people take things for granted. Everybody is so friendly. Even when I just walked in here to do this taping, people say hi to you. And it's a warm, sincere. It's not like the mechanical corporate, you know, that they've got to come up and say hi. You can tell they mean it.
I came from a larger bank, and I didn't really understand community banking until I started here. It is a different animal, and it's very fun.
It reminds me of being a kid growing up, and you walked into, you know, the old hometown bank where there's only one of, and, you know, they knew you by name. And that's kind of how it is here, and that's what I like about it.
Yes. And again, I got to thank you again, your partner sponsorship. We were a true partner with us, too. And we have other partners, but we could not do the things we do in recreation. We could not service the community with the event we are doing without your support. So we really appreciate it.
Well, and it's the major support because First State Bank, as you saw in a clip, they presented us a check for $6,000, which we really appreciate it because, as I was saying, we're the last event, to my knowledge, in the state, if not definitely Macomb County, where it's free because we don't charge for the shuttle buses, we don't charge for parking, we don't charge for admittance, we don't charge for the concert, the fireworks, everything is 100% free unless you're basically eating, drinking, or using one of the glow things.
And we should mention real quick that date is July 9th.
It is July 9th, 5:45.
Yep. We do have shuttles from the two schools.
We have shuttles from Erie Elementary, St. Paul's, depending on their parking lot, the maintenance. We normally also use Bud Park, depending if it's underwater or not.
Yep.
Last year it was. And then there's plenty of parking in the Civic Center and around the area. The only thing we do want to remind you is it's a non-alcoholic event because it's a family event. And don't park in the neighborhoods because police will ticket you. Yep. But other than that, it's supposed to be 85 degrees. I saw the forecast. It's sunny. I'm definitely watching that because we don't have a rain out date. So
they get there early and put their blankets out early. We know they've been doing that.
They
have them out already?
Not yet.
But they start pretty early.
Early in the morning.
I was going to say I come in before 9 and there's already 3 dozen blankets out there or more.
It's been a great event, and thanks for bringing it to the township and supporting the rec department and getting these events there.
It's been a pleasure doing it. Our first time we did it was 1,500 people, and now they say the count is around 10,000.
I don't know how you get a count,
But I believe it with the amount of people.
I can tell you how many faces we painted.
How many faces did you paint? Do you have any idea?
I think around 300.
Wow.
Really? I thought it would have been 3,000 with the amount of kids running around there.
There isn't a splash zone here, but in some of the others where we do this, they'll go in the splash zone and they'll wash it off and they'll come back and go, didn't I see you before? So,
well, it's a wonderful event. You know, that we want to thank you and First State for being our major sponsor and doing what you do for the community. Because it's not just the fireworks concert. You do so many other things for not only Clinton Township, but Macomb County.
Right. So we were voted Corporate Citizen of the Year this year for the Macomb Business Awards.
Congratulations.
Wow, congratulations. Yeah. That's an honor.
It was.
Well, thanks for being our partner again, and I know we got to wrap this up, and he's going to edit us and make us look wonderful at the end, but I want to thank First State Bank, want to thank Dean, and thank Kathleen, the Director of Marketing.
And I will see you there on July 9th. I will be directing the line for face painting.
And you're going to be painted already?
No, I'm going to have to think about what I want to be, because last year was not good.
Well, thank you again.
You know, we thank you, and we hope everybody comes out, has a good time. And thank you, Kathleen. Thank you, Frank.
We'll see you out there.
See you on July 9th.
All right. Well, it was fun. I was there with Dean Reynolds, that Dean Reynolds guy, man. You know, he's a character. I love being there with Dean, and he's always makes my job interesting for me. But Dean did a great job, and Kathleen, we're excited that you're the lead sponsor, and I know we thanked you a million times there. I'm going to thank you one more time, First State Bank.
At least one more time,
that they're going to be there for us, and they're the reason why these fireworks here and a lot of other organizations donate. They're our lead sponsor. You know, it's a $25,000 event. It's put on by sponsors. The entire thing's paid for by them.
Yep.
Really appreciate it, and thanks for the little bit. But after the fireworks happens, we have our own concert series. We have the Goldfish Swim School Concert Series. Again, a major sponsor for us has been Goldfish Swim School. They've come through for a lot of programs. They're located on Hall Road. If you want some individual swimming lessons or some family lessons, give them a call at Goldfish Swim School right on Hall Road. Put their number, Carl, right across the bottom for us. If not, go to our Facebook page. They're friends of ours. We like their program. They like our program. Mm-hmm. The Goldfish Swim Series, we're back. So we're going to have the following Wednesday after the 4th of July concert, July 16th, July 23rd, and July 30th. The next three Wednesdays after the concert, after the 4th of July concerts, we're going to have our own mini series. So we're going to have Dan Rafferty Band on the 16th. We're going to have Still Rain, which is a great young band, on the 23rd, and Lovesick on the 30th. I love the names of the bands we book. Not going to be the size of the 4th of July, just so we know. 4th of July is a big concert series that day. Our series is still going to be a great concert series. We won't have the carnival rides out there, but we're still going to have pre-show activities from 6:30 to about 8 out in that area. We're going to have a small children's area, so we'll have like the tent with the musical instruments.
You've been trying to make it work for me.
We're going to have the face painters. Our face painters are Two Clowns. They're not Two Clowns. That's the name of their organization. They're called TwoClowns.com. I better make sure, but I'm positive it's TwoClowns.com. But they're the ones that do the face painting at the Tiger Stadium. So we're going to have full face painters out there. So the same ones you see at the 4th of July, we just said, you know what? They're so good. Let's just keep them for all three concert series. So we're going to have them. We're going to have Roscoe out there. We're going to get some bouncy thing. I'm trying to get the big slide. You know, some big slide
out
there.
Those are fun.
If not, there'll be something out there, some other entertainment. So not as big of as a pre-show, not the carnival rides and all that, but still a really great show. And Goldfish is going to be there, and they're going to be doing their own activities that they always do with the kids. And you'll get to find out about Goldfish Swim School, our lead sponsor. We're going to have a food truck out there, little mini food truck series, so you can come out there and plan to eat. So come out there, grab some food, watch some great music. And again, the concerts are from 7:30 to 9 p.m. That's when they're playing. The pre-show activities start at 6:30, and all of this is free except for the food. So, can't beat it. I'm so glad the Township's bringing that back, and you haven't been to one.
Yeah, it hasn't been here since I've been around, so.
I used to go to them all the time, and Linda Walter worked them. Now Linda Walter left, so Frank will be working them, but I still get to enjoy it. You're going to go what I did, yeah.
Yeah.
Bring your bike up there and ride around. It's just really great to see. So, Goldfish Swim School, thank you, lead sponsor in that program.
All right, I'm going to switch it over. We have few health and safety type programs. We have our babysitter training boot camp program.
Great name.
This is a program for 11 to 15 year olds. And what it is we teach you the essentials for if you want to go be a babysitter, you want to get into any childcare type of work. And you also, this is why it's the boot camp version of it, you get certified in CPR and first aid. So we have fully trained and certified American Red Cross instructors run this program. They teach you all the essentials. You watch videos, you do activities, and you get hands-on practice and training with those mannequins that we have. So babysitter boot camp, it's a great way for, 11-year-olds, it's hard to find a CPR class for 11-year-olds out there. So even if you're just interested in that part of the program, it's going to run Saturday, August 16th. This one, it's $66 for residents. And for that price, you get a ton of things you get to take home. So you get the training, you get your certifications, so you get your cards and your certificates. You also get a babysitter handbook, a CD with all the printable materials, so you got to go babysitting for 4 or 5 hours. You're like, oh, what am I going to do with these kids? Load up the CD. There's tons of stuff on there for you to do. We also send you home with a first aid kit and a babysitter bag.
It's a great deal.
The value is fantastic there. And like I said, just getting the CPR and first aid alone.
If you are a parent out there and you're looking, how do I get my kid a job at, 11 years old, 12 years old? It's impossible to get him a job, but you can get him a babysitting job. I know everyone we interview says, I've been a babysitter since I've been 10, 11 years old. My daughter took the program, and I went in there and saw the class being done, and wow, the stuff they get from it, I was amazed because my daughter took it, and they get these, like she said, the printed materials, and it has like a checklist, and it has everything on there they should be aware of. They teach them how to go to an interview with a family because they go to the interview, and they say, this is what's your behavioral management plan, or what should I do if this happens? And it's so impressive when a kid comes into my home, and right. I have little kids, and they're reading this stuff off to me and asking the expectations for the babysitter. What do you expect of me for discipline? What do you expect from me for this? You're CPR first aid certified at this age. You're this professional. You're this mature. The class is worth every penny. and you're going to get jobs, and you're going to be able to be babysitting from 11 years old up. I mean, I don't know what they recommend, but I know at 11 and 12, everyone's looking for babysitters already. How old do they have to be in that program?
11 years old.
So there it is.
Perfect. Hence I know. I got a 12-year-old niece, and she's like ready, like jumping the gun. She's like, I want to get out there. I want to go babysitter. I want to do something. You know, I watch my brothers and sisters all the time. I want to get out there. And so it's a perfect program.
And with that training, I think they probably get paid a little extra money after you hear that. It'd be hard.
Can't hurt to ask.
Yeah. How do you give them a little bit of money when you see the training they had?
Yep.
All right. Well, I see something funny on here. It's August 16th was your program, and August 16th is my program. But Summer Dodgeball Tournament, just a quick reminder to those high school and middle school kids. We used to have dodgeball here all the time. We're having a dodgeball tournament Saturday, August 16th, 12 to 5 p.m., ages 6th to 8th grade. Sunday, August 17th are the older ones, 12 to 5 p.m. again, ages 9th through 12th grade. They are co-ed. They can be individual. You can do all females. You can do co-ed. You can do males. Dodgeballs, I don't think there's a barrier at all. Anybody could play that game. If you got dodgeball mentality, it doesn't. I heard Karen did good last night. I was cracking up.
I saw her name on a list. I don't know if that means she won.
She got on the trophy. She was like, they called me and said, I told her I taught her everything she knows, of course. But any age loves dodgeball. If you're watching this right now, I don't care how old you are, you love dodgeball. I do get parents that say dodgeball is not safe, and I went through this over and over again. Dodgeball is a safe activity if it's ran properly, using the right equipment with the right goals and objectives that we have in the game. The goal isn't just to splatter everybody like in the old days, and we don't use volleyballs or bocce balls. I know. We use regular low-dense foam balls so we don't have concussions. We have other objectives instead of hitting just people. We have bowling pins in the back. When they knock those over, the game can end a lot of different ways.
Yep.
Strategically, we have reinvented dodgeball, and it's gone over really big with all the kids, and they love it. So that's our summer dodgeball. And I don't know if you have another one. I do have a couple, so you want to jump to yours?
I got a little bit more.
We'll go to yours then.
All right, so similar to the babysitter boot camp training, we also offer the full adult, infant, and child CPR, first aid, and AED training. So this one does add on. So maybe they took the babysitter training when they're younger.
Yeah.
Now they're older. Saturday, August 9th, we're going to be running, once again, fully Red Cross certified instructors running the program. You get the videos, you do the tests and practicals and everything like that.
You got to pass the test.
Yes, you have to pass the test.
Yeah, a little pressure.
It's not too bad. We walk you through it. But it's, I think most jobs out there these days, you pretty much need to be certified, even if not for your job, just for
your family,
your own well-being and knowing and comfort of knowing you would know what to do in an emergency situation.
And I am certified. I went through the class last year. We have to go through every time. You're an instructor.
Yeah.
I've never been an instructor. You got that on me. It doesn't take too long. How long is the class?
No,
typically?
This one, we say 8:30 to 1:30.
Yeah. That's not too bad. It used to be like 8 to 5 and take up a bunch of the day. But for that training and that short of time,
right,
it's you get some valuable stuff. I mean, I don't like to even talk about the story, but I actually had to do CPR the day I was certified. We lost an individual at a party, and I was there, and I literally just was certified in CPR from Central Michigan University. Went to a party that night, and a gentleman fell in front of me, and I was like, was it a surprise quiz? It was like surreal at the time. I went down and did what I was trained to do. The police, the ambulance came there. We found out he did have a pulse when he left. They told me that. And then after, he passed away in the hospital, so it was very sad. But the family came up after and wanted to know who was the one that did CPR. It was me and my cousin at the time. They had the two man.
Yeah.
And they came over to us, and they were hugging us, and I was all teary-eyed and crying, but they said, just for you trying meant so much to our family, and it was very emotional for me. And then there was a gentleman there that was a younger guy that was crying really bad. I thought he was related. And he came back and said, no, I was trained in CPR, but I ran out of the building. I was too afraid to do it.
Yeah.
So it does happen, but do I feel better that I had the training? Yeah, when it happened, I knew what to do. I was ready to do it. And
right.
And anyone that can make any effort to save somebody, I mean, I think it's great that we provide this service for our residents.
Yep. And on that one, I know sometimes we get Girl Scout troops, Boy Scouts calling like, hey, you know.
It's a badge,
can,
right?
Can you certify? Yeah, they have. I know it's a badge they do have for Boy Scouts at least. If you have a group of 10 or more people that you want to be certified, give the office a call. So once again, 586-286-9336. Give us a call. We have instructors that we can line up a class for your group. So we can, I mean,
we've done it already. We worked with City of Berkeley, right? They came out.
Yep, they came out and we did some of their summer staff.
And it's not that bad of a price, but we recoup our cost, which the taxpayers would want and the elected officials. So we recoup those costs and we're providing a great service for recreation professionals. They were in our field, right?
Absolutely.
All right, well, I'm going to jump to a brand new program, and we love brand new programs, and they start out small, but they're going to get big, and I'm challenging my staff, first of all, to register for this. Elected officials, township employees, we are having our first major egg toss competition. And yes, it's the true line up across from each other, an egg toss, bragging rights for the city, for the township. You're going to get shirts that say Township Champs. Those are, you cannot buy those. Even though people have tried to offer me money for those shirts, you cannot buy that shirt. You have to earn that shirt. So this is one way you could get our Township Championship shirt. Also, a portion of each of the registration fees are going to go towards a major prize. So the more people we get, the bigger that major prize is. And so the egg toss is going to be your typical two people across from each other, toss the egg. We're going to keep backing up. We already have a bunch signed up for it. I'm excited that they're signing up for it, and our staff's already talking. Emily Minna's whole kickball team, they're already challenging the other kickball players out there. So we have a lot of people talking about this egg toss, and I'll tell you why. There's a little spin to it. First of all, it's Saturday, August 2nd. It's only $5 a team. So it's $2.50 a pop to come out on a Saturday at 3 o'clock p.m. at the Toboggan Hill. So here's a little twist on it. We're going to do the egg toss. You're going to toss back and forth, and we're going to have a winner in the egg toss. But then we're going to go for King of the Hill. And this is brand new, and I know we have video on this because Carl already pulled it for me. They said it couldn't be done, but we know it can be done. We're going to have each team member, well, we're going to have every team separate. Someone's going to be on the bottom of the hill. Someone's going to be on the top of the Toboggan Hill. And you're going to have an egg toss into a certain area. You're going to start in a square. We're going to throw that ball from the throw an egg from the top of the Toboggan Hill. And you're going to have to catch that ball clean without it breaking. And if you do that, you move on, and we'll keep going until we crown King of the Hill.
King of the Hill.
And I'm hoping Kim Meltzer, she was talking that she wanted to be a part of this. I'm expecting Kim Meltzer to be out there. She wants to be the first Queen of the Hill is what she told me. So I don't want to offend anybody, but we're calling it King of the Hill right now. So Kim says she wants it to be Queen of the Hill. If she wins it, she will be my Queen of the Hill. So it's a challenge out there for, I guess, the guys and the girls. You win it, you're Queen of the Hill, or you're King of the Hill. We'll find out, huh? I know Frankie, my son already, he's going to be winning the videotape with his friend Zach. He pulled off two catches in a row, his first two attempts.
I couldn't believe he got on the first try.
First two attempts. I mean, I know I could edit it to make it look like that, but I can't show Zach. Zach did not do it on any attempt.
No.
And Zach was in the ground, so I would recommend whoever's catching have some softer hands, be a receiver that can understand the theory of, cradling. You don't go up to catch it, Zach, but I'm teasing. Zach did a good job, but he did get dirty. I wish I could show the video. He's so funny.
Good.
Yeah, he would hang me. All his friends at Chippewa would love to see it, but if you come over to my house, I'll show all his buddies. I still have it on my phone. But egg toss, it's called the Excellent Egg Toss, $5. Saturday, August 2nd, get you in both competitions. And King of the Hill is, I'm excited. We'll see who's going to be our first King of the Hill. I usually have a rule that I can't win because I'm going to be running the event. But usually, typically, we say that staff can't win. This one, staff can win because they're going to be catching an egg. And they're going to be registered eggs by me. This isn't a random draw where we can draw someone's name. You're going to have to catch it. So if you're in it, you're going to be in it, you think, or not?
I might have to.
You might help me work it. I don't know. I mean, I see how many.
We'll see.
If we end up with 50, 100 groups, I might need you to help me work it. But come on, for $5, August 3rd, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, anybody, business owners, make this a fun event for your business. Get your employees fired up. Say, we want to represent the Dairy Queen. We want to represent CJ Barrymore's. We want to represent our, the businesses in our community. Say, we want our name as King of the Hill. So sign up your employees for $5. What a staff motivation thing. And get some businesses to compete against each other. I'd love to see it become a business thing. And then we'd want our staff to win.
Right.
Then they would say we had hard-boiled eggs. But we do have a rule. Even in my family, egg toss. If you win the egg toss or King of the Hill and you've got an egg, you know how you know how do you verify if it's real or not?
Do you crack it on their head?
We make them crack it over their partner's head.
Oh, yeah.
So that'll be a tradition forever. So that's just the egg toss, and I'm very excited about it, as you can tell. But we play it with our kids at day camp. They're going to be practicing, and I don't have the age group on it, but it's like 12 and up or 11 and up.
I think it was 12 and up.
It's 12 and up, so kids in our day camp program will be practicing, and they'll be ready for it. So that's a new program, and I'm excited. And again, it's after summer, so it'll be something to look forward to.
All right. Well, I have year-round offering from us, our dog park.
Oh, yeah.
Always like to bring this one up because it is there year-round, and this is like prime time to be out there. I know I've been out there this past few weeks checking out the aerobics classes, making sure everything's going good. And every time I walk by that park, there's a handful of dogs out there just running around playing. So for our dog park, all you need to do is you can come into the office, or you can get the application online. We need the filled out application. We need a paper copy of your dog license. And then your vaccine records for rabies, DHPP, and Bordetella. You bring that into us. There's a one-time fee for your key fob to get into the park. That's part of our security system to make sure it's well-maintained and all the dogs in there are...
It's like 10 bucks.
Yeah, it's a $10 fee for a one-time purchase of the
key
fob.
They keep it forever.
Yeah, never want it back.
Yeah, exactly.
You keep it. and then an annual fee for your park membership. So for residents, that's $9. For seniors out there, it's only a $7 fee.
Great.
Once a year. Park is open dawn to dusk. If you give our office a call, we can kind of let you know what the dawn to dusk would fall
entail,
in for. Yeah. And we have, I mean, it's great for owners. I know a lot of the owners out there, they got their own Facebook group they started.
Yeah,
it's like a club out there for them. It's a good social gathering.
How many dogs we have now in the park? Registered, like 400?
Oh,
over 400?
Yeah. Over 400 for sure.
I know it's a very popular park, and again, we're not patting ourselves on the back. We get this feedback, mm-hmm. and we get people that leave other dog parks and said, wow, this has a fence that you can't get in unless the dogs are cleared medically and have their and, you know, their vaccinations. If there's a problem with the dog park, they can meet with us, which we've done in the past.
Yep.
And we find out, we separate those dogs or those...
Find out what...
Yeah, or those residents. We found out who really needs to be separated.
You never know where the problem begins.
And it's a very popular park in our area. They're calling us from other communities saying, hey, we hear great stuff about your park. What do you guys do that all these people are raving about your park? I think we just provide what a good dog park should have. Open space for them to run. We're a little strict on our rules, which a lot of people like because they want to make sure that the dogs are in there, have all these vaccinations, and they should be in there for the right reasons. We have two separate areas. We have a small area, an area for smaller dogs or dogs that aren't comfortable being socially involved with the other dogs, so they can go in a different area. We are going to be adding some shade areas. I'm saying that on air. We did get approved for some money to get some shade in that area, so we're going to find out how we're going to get that shade in there. You know, a lot of our dog park people say, can't you just plant a bunch of trees? Trees don't go over well in a dog park because then you get rooting problems in there, and you get the roots that cause mud holes that can injure a dog if they run through there 5 years, 10 years from now. We don't want a big rooting problem in there. So we are trying to look at what's current trends in dog parks. We're looking at California. We're looking at Florida. We're trying to keep it, you know, where it's up to date. And I'm proud of our park. If you got over 400 and whatever it is, 50 dogs, I think we're doing something right in our dog park. And we're providing, you know, recreation for our residents. And our residents include little puppy, hairy dogs.
Part of the family.
Not part of my family. I've never had a dog. My grandpa had a Chihuahua, and I understand dogs. It's so sad when we see people lose dogs, and they come there and put their, what's the thing they can buy, and they can put it on the fence?
They look like license plates.
Yeah, but it's like the memory thing that Linda did for her dog, Linda Walter, and I'm like, I'm such a softie. I can't take it. So we had a rabbit, and the rabbit didn't last like 2 years, and I'm like, I can't take it. They're like family members out there. We know that. So I'm proud we provide that service because there's residents here that have dogs, and they say, these are my children. Mm-hmm. And the elected officials years ago, when they looked at a dog park, and said, Frank and Linda, are we really looking to do a dog park? And we said, you got to do a dog park. It's becoming popular. It's a trending thing in recreation. And I'm glad we did it, and I know the residents here appreciate it. And obviously, they got their own Facebook page, and they're having fun with it.
They're into it.
Do you have any more left?
I do not.
Okay, I've got one more then since we're going to close out. But I want to mention, if you are looking to advertise with us or be a partner with us, like Goldfish Swim School, First State Bank, and of course, Simply Self Storage has been with us a long time. And I got to plug Simply Self Storage. They're in our brochure every time. They take a half-page ad out. We do a professional exchange with them. They give us some storage. We inadvertently printed their wrong number in there.
Yeah.
And I told Jamie, she's wonderful. If you ever go on Hall Road, look for Jamie. She's the manager up there at the Hall Road Simply Self Storage. But we want to make sure that we get those numbers right out there because Hall Road, the phone number is 469-4888. Romeo Plank is 263-9610. And Garfield is 263-5520. If you have any storage needs, we have worked with Jamie up there and all the Simply Self Storages. They do a fantastic job out there, and they're a partner with us. They're a true partner. So if you want to be a partner with us, like these organizations, or want to advertise in our brochure, our brochure reaches over 40,000 residents over 40,000 households, over 95,000 residents. We're on, you know, as a partner, we can get you on cable TV. We can give you a presence here. We can give you a presence at the events. We can give you naming rights, like the Goldfish Swim School concert series. We put you on Facebook. We put you on flyers. You're in all our news releases.
Everything.
We try to put you in everything because they're a true partner. And that's why when I say a partnership, I know businesses, I'm talking to businesses out there while I'm talking to residents. But when years ago, we used to go and ask a business to say, you know, in Metro Vision, we'd go up and say, can you give us $500? We want to run an event. And they would go, okay, here's $500. And I felt like we were begging, you know, back then. We went to some, you know, luckily the township, you know, elected officials allow us to go and continue our education, allow us to go to state conferences. And we talked with small business owners and say, when we come and ask for $250 or $500 or whatever the amount is, in Goldfish Swim School and First Day Bank, they give a lot more money than that. But when we go and ask a small business and say, what can we do? And they said, you know, we really want value for that money. So now we went and we relooked at this and we said, wow, we can get you on cable. We can put you in Facebook. We can put you in front of residents. You can set up a tent at an event.
Yes.
Now it's not hard to go ask for $205 or $500 if we can show that you're a true partner with us. So we can't run a lot of these events and can't give the value to the programs without the partnership. And we appreciate everyone. Go through our brochure. Make sure you visit these locations that are our true partners with recreation. They see the quality of life issues are important for all residents in Clinton Township. They remember when they were kids or they currently have kids and they want to be associated with a good program. And I feel we do a great job. Linda Walter, who's gone now, you know, she's not gone. She's just working in Detroit. But she, you know, she laid the foundation here. I'm just going to be continuing it as the new director, which I don't even think I mentioned before. But I'm the new director, but I've been an assistant director for 25 years. And I just want to continue that relationship with our businesses. And I also want to continue the relationship with our residents. I got a great phone call today from a mom that called at Ottawa Day Camp and was raving about the program and how great it was. These kids are so mature. The program's so great. So I got her name for a future family testimonial. We can't make everybody happy all the time. And there's some people that have expectations that we try to reach. And if we don't, we need that through evaluation processes.
Yeah.
And I'm happy with the direction we're going. This summer has been very busy. You're going to see better things and more things in our community. And if you have input, let us know. We can't do anything without you, you know, letting us know. So become a member. Be a fan of our fan page on Facebook at facebook.com/myctpr. All those ways to reach us, call us 286-9336. So if you're a business out there that want that, or if you're a resident that have some needs that you say we'd like to see, like pre-3 programming, we are looking to do those things. So I guess that's just the end of the summer, and then we're already working on our fall brochure, which will come out, I don't even know, the end of August, first week of September.
Yeah, registration right after Labor Day.
Right after Labor Day. So I guess that's it. We covered a lot. We told Johnny it was going to be quick. It wasn't that quick, but my name's Frank. This is Tammy. And we want to thank you for watching another edition of Recreation Review. We'll see you next week or maybe next month. We'll see you when we can catch up with you later.